Another day, another buildup. We're digging into AMT's Dodge Charger Daytona. Part of the Stamp Art Auto Series. Beautiful rendition of the U.S. stamps on there. It's got a collectible tin. It's got some option parts like the racing hood. Got the sweet Charger bucket seats. They call it the whale tail. It's the giant wing off the back. You can put a blower on the motor if you want. It's got the nice rally wheels. It's got some other options in the box. So we're going to take a look at everything that's in the box when you get yours. And then by the title, you can see that I'm going to be doing a tribute to Joe Dirt. No, not a screen exact replica, because I just simply don't do those, mainly to head off the whiners before they even start running their mouths. I just want to build something similar, and I build out of the box for a full review, which means I don't add a bunch of other parts that people watching the review will assume that their kid has in it. I build right from the box. We'll do as close as we can to Joe's car and leave it at that, and I'll be happy with it. We've got the nice interior here. We got the rear seat molded in. The two front seats, of course, are out. The console is out, which gives us a chance to spray that interior and do it up the way we wish to do it. Blank on the bottom because it sits right on top of the chassis. The chassis is right here. It's got a lot of our work done for us. It's got the gas tank molded in. It's got our front suspension molded in. Should make it harder to have the car sitting on three wheels. Should let you build it up nicer, more evenly. And we can paint and detail that stuff, weather it, and have our fun. There's the big Charger body. Pretty much a regular Dodge Charger as it sits. And then we can get to work on it. Add the nose for the Daytona. Add the wing. Paint it all up, but it is nice looking. It definitely looks competent of the part, and that's not a problem. We've got our nice 426 Hemi parts. That thing got a Hemi in it. It's the only thing that gets Joe excited. Big ol' Hemi. Got our exhaust, intake, fan, oil pan, air cleaner, fuel pump, oil filter on the front, water pump there. Nice enough detail on it. We've got our radiator mount here. We've got our scoops for the hood. Our big giant Daytona nose. It's got the headlights molded in, so you can't raise the headlights unless you cut them out and push them up and build your own headlight inside. These are fender fillers, which will go in to complement the Charger body to put that big nose on it. We got these trees here. There's not a huge amount of parts in the kit. Should be a relatively simple build. We got that Charger dashboard. Looks every bit the part. Steering wheel. Got the big hood with the ducts built into it. Ducts. Got our Charger inserts, if you're going to be building a regular Charger out of this. Got our intake for the blower. Belt. Got our big hood scoop. All optional parts you can assemblage. Got our wheel backs here, our wheel studs, center console, got our intake, looks like heads, nice looking distributor, plenty big enough if you actually wanted to wire your engine. I do not know what that is, we'll find out when we look through the instructions. We got our rear suspension and exhaust all in one, which makes it nice in that. Well, we got a little bit of a tweakage going on, we'll have to bend that. Of course, that would look good as Joe's exhaust with one going up. One going down. Maybe I'll just leave it instead of straightening it and let the bumper decide what angle it goes in. Got our springs here. I don't have anything to raise the suspension in the back like his car, but I'll see if I can just leave these pins at the very top when I glue them in instead of pushing them all the way down. Should give me that rake that his car had at least. Got our firewall and our seats are all one piece. Make those easy to work on, easy to rip up. Switching to the other side of the table. This one's got a smaller decal sheet. It's got the white, red, and black Daytona stripes. Got the Hemi air cleaner, the Hemi door logos, the wing, and the RCX 479 California plates. We got our clear parts, crystal clear, nice and thin. Those will go in, look lovely. Metal axle for the back end. Red taillights make our job a little bit easier on that back end. We've got red lines, black wall on one side, red line on the other, nice tread design on those. What else we got over here? We've got the last part, which is the chrome tree. We've got accessory gauges, shifter, carburation on there, one set of custom wheels, one set of rally wheels. So if you got some big old slicks, you can stick those on the back. Got our blower intake, screens, more carburation, Hemi valve covers, alternator, more carburation, charger plates, and shifter. Nice rear bumper, nice front grille if you do the actual Dodge Charger with those inserts. Got our fuel tank cap. So we got a nice size chrome tree, and that is it. That's all the parts in the box aside from the manual. I'm gonna get the building up and I'll be right back. I'm ready to throw some paint at Joe Dirt's tribute Daytona, the similarity to Joe Dirt, I should say. We've got the body ready, the wing, we've got some parts, so let's take a look. All the parts here, the dashboard, steering wheel, console, the grill parts just here so I have something to grab onto when I paint these three upper parts. We're going to be spraying all those black and doing some cracked dashboard stuff like that, what we can do with the parts in the kit. We got the seats here, we got the differential and the springs, we'll be spraying all that, and then I will be detailing the seats separately and we can glue those in. We've got the interior tub which I will be painting up. I already attached the firewall to it with model glue. That's ready to go when we put that on the inside of the car. That will sit yonder back there. On the main frame there really is no work to do except I glued in the radiator mount underneath. We'll get that all patched in. And I don't know what the original color of this car was. I think in the movie it was like an originally a plum crazy, but I don't remember them showing underneath the hood of the car or anything like that. So you can make up your own version. If you want to do it film accurate, you should look it up more. But I'm just going to do an exterior shot and make up whatever I want for under the hood because I didn't see it in the movie. We got our wheel backs ready to go. We just glue our axles in there. The console, the wheel backs. I still don't know what this is. I looked through the manual twice. So if you know what that is in the comment section, tell me what it is. Be nice, but tell me what it is. And we are all set to go. I probably just missed it in the manual. The valve covers are cut free. I don't want them chrome on Joe's ride. I want them a flat black. So I will put those over there. We got the air cleaner, the belt, and the battery. So we're gonna be painting all that. Then I will remove the belt system and the battery, and I will chrome out that air cleaner for the Hemi on there. We'll put that underneath the hood. The Hemi itself, got it all together. Goes together nicely. One large piece, I did glue the manifold headers on. Those I will paint up separately, but we'll get the whole engine sprayed. We'll do the transmission. We'll get it oiled up. We'll get it greased up. We'll get it a little beat up, and we'll be all set to go on that little bad boy. The body parts are here. The wing goes together. It is a little tricky. I use super glue. It is just a butt join. Luckily, I'm doing the Joe Dirt car, the beat up car, so it won't matter if it's perfectly straight or anything. On yours, you'll have to be much more careful. On a weathered build, it actually looks a little better if it's tweaked to the side or back or something. But they go together with just butt joins, so be careful on those when you put it together. The body goes together in a very odd way. It's not a horribly bad, I've just never seen anything like that before. First off, you'll notice I have two big holes in the hood. The Daytona on Joe Dirt does not have the reverse scoops on the fenders to let air out of the front wheel well so the front end doesn't lift up off the ground at speed. They were holes with reverse scoops on them. The scoops are not there, it's just the holes in the fenders. So I took a drill bit on a regular drill and drilled holes in the top, put the hood in to make sure it still fits, and then I glued the nose on. The nose goes on very peculiarly. These fender inserts that fit on the outside, they go up at an angle, and you know that because the turn signal light should be straight with the body, should be level with the ground. Then I attached the nose with super glue on the back side because I wanted it to hold tighter and faster. Then I used super glue gel to fill in the gaps as much as I could. There's going to be gaps there. I'm not going to worry about it. If you want yours to look nicer, you're going to have to put body filler in there and sand it all down. Work it with your sanding sticks and work it down, and you can smooth those joints to perfection. But in Joe's world, that nose piece has been bumped and bent a few times, so it's okay if there's some gaps. You're going to be able to see the gaps now because the super glue is clear. But they're actually filled, and the paint will fill those in, so it'll just look like a rough join, like he tack welded it with his Harbor Freight welder. But always make sure that the hood goes on and fits while you're doing that, so that you don't have mistakes. And when you're working on the hood, There are super tiny. See those little bumps there? You got one on the front of each fender. Don't sand or cut those off. That's what holds the front of the hood in place. Those little fine bumps are what hold that in. So I will attach the wing towards the end. It gets painted black. The trunk lid is black. As far as I know from the pictures, I'm going to check them again before I get painting. The hood is black. The doors are primer. The fenders are faded blue. The nose and the main body are yellow. So I'm going to get all that work done right now over in paint.
Thank you. Thank you.
beating these cars up is always a heck of a good time because I don't have to buy a real Charger Daytona and wait 50 years for it to go to hell. So we're going to take a look at what I've got done, remembering I'm just using parts and roughly making it look like the movie car, not an exact perfect show-stopping replica. I've got the chassis all with major rust and wear. This car is definitely roached out, so we've got a lot of wear and tear on it. We've got the newer black steely. Now this is one of the factory wheels. You can use a steel wheel from a parts pack somewhere. I just painted one of the factory ones in the kit black with a black wall tire, a much newer tire than the original Magnum tire on the other side with the red line. Still got one of those on the car. Got the bottom all crusted up. The fuel tank's rusted. The bottom has got severe deep rust on it. Under the hood, we've got a little bit of coloration, dirt, dust, and grime on the radiator. Got a newish battery in there. I didn't want to weather the battery. They're always replacing parts on these cars, so that's why you can make it look that way. We've got the Hemi all together. I've got to add some detail to it once it's actually in the chassis. I will add some oil staining, some antifreeze detail to it, and I will be done with that. But we've got the engine looking much older and rusty. I want the transmission and the bell housing as if he just put them on. Just had to throw a new tranny in that thing, man. So he's got the rebuilt transmission and bell housing looking good. On the back of that 426, the manifolds and exhaust are deeply rusted. The valve covers are black, so we'll get those a little dirty. Got the alternator all blacked out with black wash and our belt and pulley system on it. So that looks cool for underneath the hood. We've got the drivetrain rusted up. What I'm going to do is I'll use the locating pin on the exhaust to hold the one piece in place. And where this was naturally bent in the box, I cut the locating pin off of it so that I won't push it flat and it will naturally hang down, and that will add some cool effects. Now what I'm going to do to put that rear end on and give me just a little bit of a higher ride height is, of course, you have the holes. I'm not going to be using those at all. The differential has a big old groove down the bottom of it. You can see I don't paint the bottom because when it's on the car, never going to see it. What I'll do is where these posts are, I will just let them sit above those holes. So I won't push it in, they're just gonna sit there. I will then take the rear axle with the custom wheels like it had in the movie. He had big drag slicks on the back. You can go ahead and use these from AMT parts packs, these Firestone Drag 500s, or any other big slick you want. You could put those on the back if you wanted, but I'm building out of the box. So I use the custom wheels that were in the kit, the narrow ones. I'll put those on the rear with a black wheel back so they look really nice, with a red line on the outside, black wall on the other. That's gonna sit in this groove and get glued in so that when I flip it over and install it, that's gonna give me a little bit higher ride height in the rear. That's gonna give me a little bit of a rake, and not as much as I'd like to get on there with the bigger slicks, but since I'm building it out of the box for the review, that'll give me the rake I want. You can see how the exhaust is gonna sit level and down on one side. That's awesome. So that's my idea for doing that. Got the interior all done. Had to hand paint the dashboard because of course it is not included with any decals and all that. And being a Charger with the big overhang, you can't see much of it. I painted the entire steering wheel silver because he had that welded chain steering wheel. So we'll replicate that with a stock part. The pink and blue seats he did in the sheepskins, I did in paint. And then we've got the crackle pattern on the dashboard. You can see how fine it is. And in 1/25th scale, it would be that small. Same with the back seats. Dirt and crackled on the top, and a dirty package shelf on the wing. For some reason in the movie, it's got a huge silver streak down one side, a scrape, so I put that on there with some silver enamel. Otherwise, just scuffed up the wing and wore down that black a little bit so that that's ready to glue on. Weathered up and trashed the body. Completely smoked out that back window. The back window's never been cleaned. I never look behind me, man. Life's always moving forward. So I sprayed that matte clear on there for a completely crusted glass in the back. Rusted out the hood. Rusted out the trunk like they came from another car. Don't forget to do the lip on the trunk. Got the tail lights in. Got the rusty bumper in. The Charger emblem is on there upside down because I want the plate to hang down. And I'm going to be putting a plate on it. He's got a chrome trim around the plate, like you know how these guys throw weird money at weird things. Got our filler on the top. got our rust around the back window like they always do on the Chargers real bad. They always have to replace all the way around there. Got our rust on it all the way around, where our ducts were, all the way down where the fuel cylinder is, around the bottom. Got that purple spray on the door. The story behind that was they had the guy spray the jams of the door to look like this car has been repainted like 37 times. And when he cleaned out his gun, the door was still primer, so he just shot a little bit on it. This is actual production notes. David Spade saw the purple on the door and said, leave it. They would do that to one sitting in a barn. They would test out a little bit. So I used some purple metallic craft paint, squirted it on the, rubbed it on the door in a spray paint pattern, and left it. The other side is primer. So we've got our rust coming out, those rear cracks there on that one side. We've got rust on the roof from all the wear and tear and stuff being set on it in the shed. We've got rust at the base of the wing. And then I will place the wing on top and glue that. So we've got it all set to go. There's no decals to put on it, because except for the license plate that I'll stick on. But otherwise, the Hemi emblem would have been gone from the air cleaner because the chrome job's real bad on it now. It's all pitted. The stripes aren't going to be on it anymore. Those have worn off. The Hemi emblems aren't going to be on the door because the doors were just replaced. So we don't have to do any decal work. I've just got to push everything together and show you that final. With the reissue of AMT's 125th scale 69 Charger Daytona, I finally get to build the Joe Dirt Daytona. I had a lot of fun putting this one together. I like trashing out these vehicles sometimes, and I know a lot of the Superbird and the Winged Warrior, the Charger Daytona folks, they like to build pristine Mopar National show-winning cars, and I thought, I saw this, it came in this cool tin, and all I could think of was Joe Dirt. I love that movie, and I wanted to replicate the car, and now I can do it. I had a lot of fun building it up. There really are no fit issues. The car goes together well. The nose goes on completely different than I expected. It's not the smoothest, the best example of getting the nose on that car, but as a car that's retrofitted from a 69 Charger, it's not too bad, especially if you're going to junk it out like I did. If you're going to build a pristine stock version, you're going to have to do a good amount of sanding and working on that to get that to blend in perfectly. But if you got the sanding and you got the time, you can do so. I lifted the rear end, showing you how to do it with exactly the way it comes from the factory. All of this was completed and built out exactly the way it comes from the factory. I didn't add parts. I didn't do anything else. I just used what I could to build up the Joe Dirt replica as easily and as quickly as I could get it done. This was a two-day build from front to back, no issues at all. You can see underneath, hold the hood on. We got it rusted and crusted, but he's got the new transmission and bell housing on there, or rebuilt, whatever he did. We got it all set up. We got the custom wheels in the back. We got the stock wheel in the front. We got the other wheel completely blacked out because in the movie it was a steely with a little bit of a newer tire on it. That's how I did it on that one. Used a drill to drill out the fenders for those ducts so that he doesn't have the duct covers on them. So I left them open and did a little bit of crust rust around them. Outlined the headlights with a Molotow black marker and then painted in the front grille. On the movie car, the one headlight is up, this one's kind of sunken in, and that entire grille is missing. I didn't want to do that much surgery because I would have to build stuff behind it, and that wouldn't be a completely out-of-box review. So I built the car with everything I could do as is from the box only to give it a fair review as it is. It was a happy little accident that exhaust was bent out of the box. Now, if you built it stock, it has a large locating pin that will press up underneath the chassis. You'd never even know it was bent. You'd glue it into place and it would stay there forever. But for me, I cut that locating pin off, let that exhaust hang down so that it's a little bit of bent exhaust on there, and it looks just like it did in the movie with the mufflers falling off of it and all that stuff. So we saw him when he went through in the movie when they put the gate down to the security booth at the radio station, rip the ring wing right off, so you could also do that part. You could put make a little diorama, snap the wing off or whatever. I left it on there. I did that little bit of silver streak on it, on the wing like it has in the movie. I did the purple spray on the primer door, the blue fenders, the completely roached out trunk lid and hood on it, and just had a blast, which is what I recommend you do. You should smile, have fun, realize this is just a hobby, and build every single one of your models for you and you alone. Once again, Thanks to AMT Round 2 Models for sending over this review sample. We'll see all of you at the next review.